part in the land of Israel, Be'eretz Yisrael, Be'ezrat Hashem.
Amen. Amen.
Dear ladies, this Shabbat is Parashat Chukat. I'm reminding you, Hashem gave me zchut to give lessons about Parashat Chukat. It's Parah Aduma, it's the red cow, Besiyata Dishmaya. So please go to TorahAnytime.com or RabbanitEars.com or the YouTube Be'ezrat Hashem and you'll have shiurim about this. Today we're going to finish the subject we were speaking about, that we are not allowed to marry non-Jewish people. So today we're going to conclude everything that we did. Besiyata Dishmaya. You remember we spoke about Dinah, the daughter of Yaakov, and Shechem ben Chamor, Besiyata Dishmaya. We spoke about Yosef HaTzadik and the wife of Potiphar. We spoke about Shulamit Badivri, the wife of Datan, that the Egyptian came on her and she came pregnant from him and she had a boy called Shlomo HaMelech, Shlomo the son of King David. And we spoke, the last thing that we spoke was Shimshon HaGibor, Shimshon the Mighty, Samson the Mighty. And you remember we said that he had the spark of Mashiach ben Yosef, of Besiyata Dishmaya. So, dear ladies, it's written Parashat Vaetchanan, Velo titchaten bam, you're not allowed to marry, it's a mamash halacha, it's a Jewish law, you're not allowed to marry the nations. Lo titen livno, bitcha lo titen livno, you won't give your daughter to his son, and you won't take his daughter to your son. That's a halacha from Hashem, that we are not allowed to get married to non-Jewish people. So dear ladies, Besiyata Dishmaya, now we're going to come. I went through Rabbi Pinchas Friedman, Shibadel Lechaim Tovim Vershalita, Shibadel Lechaim Tovim Vimbarukim, and Besiyata Dishmaya, and Tisera Chamim, and a few things Hashem helped me to gather. And I want to show you how will we be saved, Besiyata Dishmaya, from this Galut, from this exile. And it's all connected to the way that we behave with the non-Jewish people and the way we behave with ourselves, among ourselves, the Jewish people. So there are five places, it's written, Chazal say, our sages say, there are five places in the Torah, that the name of Yaakov Avinu appears, Yaakov, with Vav. Five places that the name of Yaakov Avinu appears with Vav. Usually it's without Vav, like this. There are five places in the Torah that the name of Eliza the prophet, Elisha Navi, Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu, appears like this, without a Vav. Usually it appears with a Vav. But there are five places that it appears without the Vav. And why? Because Yaakov Avinu took the Vav from Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu the prophet. And why? In order to remind him that he will come at the end of days to announce the salvation, the Geula, to the to the children of Israel. Besiyata Dishmaya, five places. Baruch Hashem. Five places. So let's start. Where do we see Yaakov with a Vav? We see it in Parashat Bechukotai. Parashat Bechukotai, the end of Chumash Vayikra. And for all the ones that say that Hashem forsaken the children of Israel, if they don't listen to him, they just need to read Parashat Bechukotai without even considering all the other verses in the Torah. Parashat Bechukotai. Over there, you remember there are two portions of Torah that they have over there, that Hashem says, if you don't listen to me, this and this is going to happen to you. It's the opposite of blessings, what are written, but eventually everything will become a blessing. At the end, it says like this, V'zachart yet briti Yaakov, with a Vav, you see it over here? V'af et briti Yitzchak, I will remember my treaty with Yaakov Avinu, and I will remember my treaty with Yitzchak, our forefather, and I will remember my treaty with Avraham Avinu, which Avraham, our forefather, and I will remember the land. Dear ladies, and I will remember the land. You see over here, Yaakov is with Avav. We go to Malachi the prophet, and over there it's written, Hinei Anochi Sholeach Lachem, at the end of days, I'm going to send to you Eliyah. It's not written Eliyahu. It's without the vav over here. You see, there's no vav. Eliyah Navi, Eliyah the prophet, lifnei bo yom Hashem gadol, before the time that Hashem is going to reveal himself, because Eliyahu Navi, Eliyah the prophet, is supposed to help us to prepare to receive Mashiach. לפני ביום השם הגדול והנורא והשיב לבבות על בנים, and his job is to bring the children of Israel closer, the children, their children, the hearts of the children, the hearts of the fathers to the hearts of the children, and the hearts of the children to the hearts of their fathers, Bezrat Hashem, that the fathers, mothers, everybody will be connected, and we will be zoche ואהבת לך כמוך אני השם. So you see over here, these are two places that Yaakov has the Vav, and Eliyah doesn't have the Vav over here. Okay? We are going to Parashat Ve'era, Chumash Shmot. Over there it's written like this, Ve'samti Pdut Ben Ami Uben Amcha. And I will put, Pdut is like salvation, between my nation, says Hashem, to your nation. למחר יהיה האות הזה. If you pay attention, פדות, the salvation is without a vav. Again here, you see? זה כתיב חסר. Without vav. And then we go to Tehillim, to King David, and it says, Tehillim 111, chapter 111, it says, פדות שלח לעצמו. לעמו, סליחה. Hashem is going to send salvation to his people. And then we go to chapter 130, which means Hashem is going to save and give salvation to the children of Israel. Both of them with Vav. Why, when he sent Moshe Rabbeinu and Aaron to Pharaoh, to Paro, it was without a Vav, and over here both of them are with a Vav. And if you'll pay attention, he says, למחר יאות הזה, tomorrow I'm going to make this sign. Because after the exile of Egypt, Nachon, Hashem gave us salvation and took us Exodus out of Egypt. But after that, we had more exiles. We were exiled by Babel, by Babylon. We were exiled by the Greeks. We were exiled by the Romans. Until now, we're still in exile. So that's why over here, there's no Vav. The salvation is without a Vav. That's why it's written, Lemachar yeah ot hazeh. Tomorrow, in the future, this sign is going to be which sign, which letter? The letter Vav. Now, I would like to tell you, what about the letter Vav? It says Bazohar HaKadosh that the letter Vav is the letter of truth. It's the letter of life. You remember Cain killed Hevel? And he came to Hashem after Hashem said to him, you're going to go to exile and that you're nabenad. I won't kill you now. So you remember when Hashem told him this? He told him, please Hashem, everybody that will see me will want to kill me. All the animals will want to kill me. Hashem made a sign on his forehead. The Zohar HaKadosh says, what was the sign? It was a letter Vav. The letter Vav was the sign on his forehead. Why? Because Vav is the letter of life, the letter of truth. How do we know that? We know Vata Mechayet Kulam. You are the one that gives life to everyone. Titen Emet LeYaakov. I told you this is the letter of life and the letter of truth. So this letter belongs to Yaakov Avinu. Why does it belong to Yaakov Avinu? Because Yaakov Avinu, it's written about him, Ish Tam Yoshev Oalim, which means he's an innocent person who sits among the tents, among the tent of Abraham Avinu and among the tent of Yitzchak, between mercy and judgment. And he's Vav, he's the Tiferet, he's the connection between them. And this is the Ot Aleph, Aleph Shelemet. This is Abraham Avinu, which is Chesed, mercy, the Yud that is upon the letter Vav, and then this is Yitzchak. And Yitzchak, the letter, you see, because it's on the left side, this is the left side, this is the right side. Among them, between them, is Yaakov Avinu, which is the Tiferet. Zetiferet. This is Vav. This is his letter. So when Yaakov Avinu was sleeping and he saw the ladder from earth comes until the sky, he saw the fourth exile, which we are inside this fourth exile, and he saw that this will take so long. He was so afraid. He said, how my children are going to be saved? So we'll show you Besiata Dishmaya. I would like to go and tell you Bezrat Hashem this. We go to, why is it so important? We go to Zecharia the prophet, chapter 13, and it says this. At the end of days, it says, I'm going to take out all of the impurity from the land. Mama, so Hashem is going to take, like you take a carpet, that's how we will take all of the impurity. Furthermore, it says that v'haya b'chol ha'aretz no'um Hashem, that will be all around the globe in the name of Hashem, pi shnayim b'ikartui gav'u v'ashlishit yivater ba, which means from humanity, two-thirds of humanity will be vanished from earth. Only one-third will stay from all of the human beings on earth. And why? Because Hashem gives us, אף פעם לא מאוחר לעשות תשובה, that's never late to repent for the children of Israel and for the nations. The nations should keep the seven commandments of Noach, and we should keep all of the 620 mitzvot that we can keep today among the mitzvot, a keter, a crown for the children of Israel, 613 from the Torah and 7 mitzvot, commandments from our sages. So Hashem says that at the end of days, two-thirds of humanity is going to vanish from earth. Only one-third. And from this one-third, it will be cleansing of that third. The way that I took you out of Egypt, I'm going to take you out of this exile. And you know that 80% of the Jewish people did not go out of Egypt. Why? Because they felt comfortable where they were. So what did Yaakov Avinu do? They felt comfortable. At the beginning, תמיד היהודי עומד על המזוודות שלו. יהודי נודד. Always with his packages, waiting, because he never knows when the nations are going to go against him. We can already see that the nations are already against us. We can see the media, we can see what's going on here. So look, when do the nations go against the children of Israel? We go to chapter 106 in Tehillim. It says, "Va'itarvu ba'goyim ve'ilmedu ma'aseim." When we mingle around and we learn from the nations, instead of doing the commandments and following the way of Hashem, Hashem says, "Bitzniut." So you have to be modest. Hashem says, "Cover your head. No questions mark. No question mark. You cover your head." Hashem says, "Keep Shabbat." You keep Shabbat. Hashem says, eat kosher because you're my firstborns. I gave you more portions of the soul. You have to eat kosher. You eat kosher. What Hashem says is the best for us because He created the world, so He knows. He created the world, so He wants to give life to the world. Hashem is interested in life, not in death. And we came over here to fix. And if we don't listen, if it comes from one ear and goes up through the other ear, oy va'avoy lanu v'nishmatenu, on the day that we are going to meet Hashem. Because this big judgment day is very close. You can see B'siyata Dishmeya that Yudzayim B'Tammuz is not this Shabbat, it's the next Shabbat. And that's why it's postponed to Sunday, the fast. And then Tisha B'Av also falls on Shabbat. And again the fast is postponed to Sunday. So B'siyata Dishmeya, Hashem bring Mashiach now. So we don't have to fast on both of them. And we'll all be in Yerushalayim Be'ezrat Hashem. And we'll see all the Kohanim, and we'll see Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi B'mehra B'yameinu Amen, Yireh Mishamayim Be'ezrat Hashem. So dear ladies, I would like to continue and show you what happened with Yaakov Avinu. All of the fixing of the end of days is connected to the letter Vav. Because I told you five places Yaakov took Vav from Eliyahu the prophet, in order that he will remember to come and to announce B'siyata Dishmaya that Mashiach is coming and help us do tshuva. So we see that Yaakov, when he came to this world, Parashat Toldot, In Parashat Toldot, it's written, I don't know if I wrote it for you over here. Okay, Parashat Toldot, it's written that Esav, they were twins. Esav came first, and Yaakov was holding his heel. Nachon? Why? There were two things. It says, our sages say that Esav was already a full human being. He had hair, he had teeth, he was a soy, made already. You know, baby, when it comes, it's all bald. You have to wait until his teeth grows. Everything is bald, b'siyata shmeh, not Esav. Esav was asui. Asui. Why was he called Esav and not asui? Because Yaakov was holding his akev. You remember his heel. So he took the yud and Hashem added the yud over here. It became Yaakov. Instead of the heel, it became Yaakov. You see, Yaakov. The initials of Yaakov Avinu is the bet is bitul, eliminating kuf klipat, the shell of Esav veishmael, which means Yaakov Avinu, by his name, he has the ability besiata dishmaya to eliminate the shell of Esav veishmael. But he was still holding his akev because he wanted also to take the vav. Because once he held, part of the good of Yaakov went into Esav and part of the wickedness of Esav came into Yaakov. Why? Because Hashem said that at the end of days, Esav can't come, his children, his descendants cannot come to me and say, well, you gave us only wickedness. We didn't have the strength to overcome our wickedness. But because Yaakov held him, part of the good of Yaakov went into Esav, and part of the wickedness of Esav went into Yaakov. So, b'siyata dishmaya, he has the power to overcome his wickedness. So, Yaakov wanted to bring the vav in order that he will be Yaakov with a vav. You remember he was fighting Parashat Vayishlach. I know I'm going for a lot of parashiot portions, but you'll go with me. We're going to travel. You remember he was fighting. He forgot part of the jars, Akadim, on the other side of the Jordan. And he went back alone. And there was the angel of Esav. And he was fighting him. And he won. Mm-hmm. And he touched his Yerech. He touched his thigh, you remember? And he told him, You're not going to be called Yaakov anymore. You're going to be called Israel. You know why he told him? Because he should have told him, you're going to have an addition to your name. But he didn't say that. He said that you're not going to be Yaakov. You're going to be called Israel. And why? Because if you look, Yaakov, plus the name Israel, Yaakov is, Kuf is 100, Ayin is 70, Yud is 10, Vav is 6, and Bet is 2. Together it's 188. And Israel, Yud is 10, Shin is 300, Resh is 200, Aleph is 1, Lamed is 30, 541. Together it's 729. Nachon? This is parallel to Kras Satan. Which means to eliminate Satan from the world. That's why he didn't tell him you have an addition on your name. Because Kuf is 100, Resh is 200, Ayin is 70, it's 370. Shin is 300, Tet is 9, and Nun is 50, it's 359, which equals 729. So Yaakov Avinu needs this Vav. What happened to the Vav? Why doesn't he have in most of the verses Vav? Only five places he has Vav. Dear ladies, it says like this. Ve'ele shmot bnei Yisrael habayim Mitzrayim. We'll go again to the beginning to Chumash Shmot. These are the names of the children of Israel who came, went down to Egypt. Okay, but pay attention. It says habayim. It's not that came to Egypt, that are coming now to Egypt. We go to the Haftarah, And in the Haftarah it says, Habayim Yashresh Yaakov, in Yeshayahu the prophet, it says in the Haftarah, Habayim Yashresh Yaakov. Which means the word Baim in present, that they are coming now, Yaakov Avinu rooted inside the children of Israel. Why? In order that they won't feel comfortable in the exile. They have houses, they have mansions, or they have, it doesn't matter what they have, that they will feel comfortable and they don't want to go and move to the land of Israel. They don't want to do what Hashem wants them to do. They feel very comfortable among the goyim. That's why it says, Bemasechet Sota, Masechet Sota, it says, Chen Makom Al Yoshvav, which means a person feels comfortable in a place, so he doesn't want to move to that place. That's what's happened in Egypt. That's why 80% of the children of Israel did not go out of Egypt. It says, V'alkut Shimoni, Parashat Shemot, it says over there, why did the Egyptians enslave the children of Israel? Because they became plenty and they started going all through the land to their tatrot.
Theaters,
and everything that they had, they start mingling with all of the Egyptians. They start mingling all around. They started eating their bread. That's why B'Shulchan Aruch it says you're not allowed to eat their bread, you're not allowed to drink their milk, you're not allowed to drink wine. Their wine. Why? Because Hashem doesn't want us to mingle, because Hashem said, you are my special people. You are the ones that I'm going to save for myself to be the firstborn. And you're the one that will give light to all of the nations. It's a job from Hashem, and it's a zchut, it's a merit to have this job. It's a merit to be born a Jewish person. It's a merit to convert and to become Jewish and to accept upon yourself the commandments of Hashem. It's a big merit, it's a big responsibility, but at the same time, it's a big merit to be Jewish. So, dear ladies, he didn't want Yaakov Avinu. He saw that we will feel comfortable. We will come and we'll feel comfortable. He didn't want this. So he enrooted inside of us that we will feel always that we'll have to have our bags next to us. We don't know when the nation are going against us. When will the nation go against us? Please pay attention. It says in Tehillim. It's unbelievable. Vayitarvu bagoyim vayilmedu ma'asem. They will mingle among the nations and they will learn all of the things that they do. And they will get married to him. And they say, and Hashem said, "Velot itchaten bam." You are not allowed to get married with the nations. And then it says in Tehillim chapter 105, "Behafach libam lisnoamo." When this happens, Hashem causes the nations to hate the Jewish people, so they will vomit them out of their country. So, dear ladies, assimilation became like a Holocaust, worse than a Holocaust. It's a quiet Holocaust. And this is the Vav, because once we assimilate with the nations and we get married to them, Esav gets his life, his livelihood from the letter Vav. Esav gets his livelihood from the letter Vav, the letter of truth, the letter of life. That's what I showed you over here. V'ata mechayet kulam, through the letter Vav. And then, titen emet le'Yaakov. This is the letter of truth. What does Yaakov Avinu want? To take this Vav. The more we mingle more with the goyim, the more there's livelihood to the descendants of Esav because of this Vav. Why? Because Vav in grammar, in the Hebrew grammar, Vav is Vav HaChibur, which means Vav of connection. It's a letter of connection. In English, I know there isn't a letter of connection. You have to say and. And I saw this and I took this and. So the Vav, our Vav, it's one letter equals to and. Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz. At the beginning, Hashem created heaven and earth. This is the connection, heaven and earth. So that's why the verse says, Ve'ahavta livriyut. Ve'ahavta lereacha kamocha. You see, ve'ahavta lereacha kamocha. It says, Ve'ahavta with a vav. It doesn't say, Ahavta. Be'ahavta, which means you should get connected to the Jewish people. You should get married with Jewish people. You shouldn't mingle. This will be the fixing of the vav that Esav took, that Yaakov is searching to take it out. At the end of days, it's written in Masechet Aduyot, En Eliya ba ela lerachek. En Eliyahu ba ela lerachek ha-mekoravin bizroa ve-lekarev ha-murhakin bizroa. Which means at the end of days, Eliyahu, the prophet, comes in order to separate the ones that are together, that are combined together, and to get closer and to combine them, the ones that are separated from each other. Who is separate from each other? If we don't have Beit HaMikdash yet and we don't have Mashiach, we are separated. We are groups. We have groups everywhere. We are not connected. We need to practice unconditional love to each other. We shouldn't judge each other. We are so fast to judge like this. We should always find the merit of each other. By finding the merit of each other, we are coming closer to each other. We're giving power to the Vav to come back to Yaakov Avinu, Besiyata Dishmaya, that Yaakov will bring it back to Eliyahu Navi in order, Besiyata Dishmaya, that Mashiach will be here. We are bringing closer the Geula, the redemption. And when once there's a redemption, it's the redemption for the whole world. En davar omed bifnei atshuva. There's nothing that stands in front of repentance, which means each and every one of us can do tshuva now. We don't need to wait. Even if we didn't listen until now, this is the time to do tshuva. Dear ladies, there's no time for covering your head, going modestly. There's no time anymore. If you look what's going on in the world, in 1 minute everything will change. And then there will be such a fear in the world, nobody can do tshuva anymore. There's no conversions anymore. Because the tshuva, the repentance and the conversion will be only because of the fear of what will happen in the world. So Hashem does not accept anymore. No tshuva, no conversion. But each and every one of us has the opportunity now. Every morning we wake up, it's one clean page. This is the day of redemption. So we shouldn't wait for anything. This is the time to do tshuva. And we see Besiyata Dishmaya. So how do we keep ourselves in order that the Vav will stay with Yaakov Avinu Eliyahu Navi, Besiyata Dishmaya? By looking at what Yaakov Avinu did. When he came, Parashat Vayishlach, from Lavan, it's written, Be'avo Yaakov Shalem. And Yaakov came as a whole. So it says, Rabbi Shimshon Mostropoli says, מה זה שלם? What is a whole? שלם, dear ladies, that he didn't change his name, שין for שם. He didn't change the language that he spoke, לשון הקודש. And he didn't change his clothing, מלבוש. He didn't go now not צניעות because he was living with Laban. But he was still tzniut, his wives were tzniut, his children were tzniut, modest. So he didn't change these three things. And the Tzemach Tzedek says, the 50th gate of impurity, when a person changes his name, his tongue, he doesn't speak anymore the holy language, and he changes his clothing. Because you remember, the name of a person influences the livelihood that he gets. What we eat is what we are. And what we dress is what we are. The language that we speak is what we are. If we speak politely to people, we're polite people. If we speak with anger or with rudeness, this is who we are. You can see it on the road, dear ladies, when you drive your car, it's a big test from Hashem to see who you really are. And then the name that you give, this is the lights of livelihood that you get from the letters of your name. If you give yourself a name that is not Jewish, that's what you will get. You have to have a Jewish name to remember your roots. Where did you come from? Who are you? Then when you remember who you are, you will not get married to the nations because you know that Hashem does not allow it. Period. You don't need explanation for this. Hashem said it's not allowed. You're not allowed to do it. So you see all of this. which means that three stars that influence, there are seven stars, and three of them influence the world, not in a good way. But by keeping your name, your language, the holy language, and your clothing, by being modest, v'siyata d'shma, you are safe from them. And one of them, it starts with a shin, it's Shabtai. The other one is Levana. And this is Ma'adim. The Mem is Ma'adim. Sachsha Mechila. I don't know if you're Shabtai and Ma'adim. Saturn, I think. Can you look at this again? Siyata Dishmaya. Shabtai comes from Shabbat. Okay? Which means keeping Shabbat. Levana means, Levana is the moon, is Besiyata Dishan Libun Shel Halacha, studying the Torah and the Jewish laws. This is Torah and Halacha, which keeps us from the influence of these stars. And then Ma'adim, dear ladies, is Mammon. Dear ladies, Mammon. Mammon is money, it's Daka. By giving Tzedaka, you're safe from the influence of Ma'adim, of this star, three stars that cause wars in the world, that cause things that are not good in the world. So by doing all of this and keeping our name, keeping our holy language, the Hebrew, keeping our clothes, being modest, b'siyata d'shmaya, we are saved from all these three stars. Keeping Shabbat, save us from Shabtai. Learning the Torah and studying the halachot, the Jewish laws.
Saturn,
it's Shabtai? Saturn, yes, Saturn, לא הייתי בטוחה. Okay. ומאדים?
Mars?
אני לא חושבת.
No.
Okay.
Mars.
Mars? Yeah, טוב. את בטוחה?
כן.
Okay, Mars. Dear ladies, so keeping it, you are safe from these three Shaloneda stars, planets that cause not good influence on the world. That means that Yaakov Avinu came Shalem. What do we learn from this? We learn from this B'siyata D'shmaya that we should keep the mitzvot of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the commandments, in order Bezrat Hashem, that there will be Geula and Hashem will take the Vav from Esav and bring it back to Eliyahu Navi and to Yaakov Avinu Bezrat Hashem. It depends on us, the way we connect to each other and the way we connect to non-Jewish people, which means Chas V'Shalom marrying non-Jewish people. It's not that they are not human beings, it's only that Hashem does not allow us to marry non-Jewish people. Hashem loves all of His creation. And Hashem gave life to all of His creation. And because Hashem created the world, He knows what's good for the world. So He says the Jewish people are not allowed to marry the nations, period. And at the end of days, B'siyata d'shmaya, when Eliyahu Hanavi will come and Hashem will give him back the Vav from Esav, you see over here, He will give it back to Yaakov Avinu. And Hashem will bring Mashiach, everything will be revealed. Mashiach will be here, that's why it's written, V'zacharti b'riti Yaakov. And I will remember my treaty with Yaakov Avinu. And I remember my treaty with Yitzchak. You see over here, the Yitzchak of forefathers. And I remember my treaty with Abraham Avinu. And if you see the Af, it says, V'af et b'riti. You see the Vav? Look over here, you see the Vav? And you know what is Ve'af? So the Vav is the Vav that connects, Vav HaChibur, but Aleph is Eliyahu, and the Pei is Pinchas. We are almost in Parashat Pinchas, and the Pei is Pinchas. You remember that Eliyahu, the prophet, includes inside him Pinchas. Pinchas HaKohen HaGadol, Pinchas Ben Elazar, Ben Aaron HaKohen, dear ladies. So this is Eliyahu that will come with the Vav Bezrat Hashem and take the Vav from Esav and bring B'siyata Nishma, announce the Geula B'mera B'yameinu Amen. שנזכה B'siyata Nishma לקדם פני משיח צדקנו ברחמים מורים B'mera B'yameinu Amen. Eliyahu נביא זכר בטוב לעולם מפחד אדם מחברו בדבר הלכה יחיד ברבים מלאכה כנו.
Amen. The Av is not the cause of Hashem.
כן, אבל פה זה לא... זה אף על פי כן נזכור אותנו. זה בפרשת בחוקותיי, שם יש כללות. אז אף על פי כן, which means, she says, this is anger of Av, it's on. Even though Hashem is going to save us and redeem us. Why? Because he promised our forefathers that we are his firstborns. And because of that, even if we won't, if we don't listen to him, eventually at the end of times, Hashem will take us and cleanse us and make our hearts a human heart, B'siyata Nishmaya.
Rabbanit Iris, I was read the book, something about from Kabbalah. If Jewish person gonna marry, it's not count, but he's with Goya. So after 120 years, his soul gonna go to Caleb.
I said that in one of the shiurim. Mm-hmm. A reincarnation of a man that was with a non-Jewish woman is a dog.
Yes, reincarnation. Mm-hmm. Gonna go to
Selaneda. Ma?